हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ रोहिणी अथे, श्री रेमिनाथ जैन विद्यालय चंडीगढ़। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक पॉलिनेशन। पॉलिनेशन मीन्स ट्रांसफर ऑफ पोलन ग्रेन फ्रॉम एंथर टू स्टिग्मा। प्रोसेस इज नोन एज पॉलिनेशन। पोलन ग्रेन्स फ्रॉम एंथर लोब दे रिलीज्ड फ्रॉम दैट आफ्टर द प्रोसेस ऑफ डिहाइसेंस एंड देन ट्रांसफर ऑन द स्टिग्मा and the process is known as pollination. Then this pollination is of two types, self pollination and cross pollination. The difference is in between self and cross pollination. The self pollination means the pollen grain and stigma both belongs from the same species, and in case of cross pollination, pollen grains and stigmas they belongs from the different species. The self pollination, it is further divided or it is further classified into two types, autogamy and zygotogamy. In autogamy, anther and stigmas both are belongs from the same flower. Flower is same, means the flowers are bisexual. Anther and stigma both belongs from the same plant and the same flower. In case of zygotogamy, anther or the pollen grains and stigmas both belong from same plant, but flowers are different. Plant species is same, but flowers are different. And these are the two types of self pollination. In case of autogamy, a single flower is used, and in case of zygotogamy, two different flowers are used, but they belongs from the same plant. Then cross pollination. In case of cross pollination, it is further classified into xenogamy and hybridization. In case of xenogamy, what happened? The anther and stigma both are involved in pollination. Anther belongs from different plant species and stigma belongs from different plant species. Means here two different plants from different plants, pollen grains and stigmas, they are being involved. They belongs from the two different plants. In case of hybridization, what happened? Anther and stigma, here also two plants are used, but they belongs from different species. Here species is also different, here species is same. In case of xenogamy, two plants are involved, but they belongs from the same species. In case of hybridization, two plants with anther and stigma, they are involved, but they belongs from different species. Once again, autogamy, flower is same. Xenogamy, two flowers are involved, but plant is same. Xenogamy, two plants are involved, but they belongs from same species. And in case of hybridization, two plants are involved, but species is different. Then the next topic belonging to the pollination, that is agents of pollination. Agents means the certain agencies, certain carriers are used to carry the anther towards the stigmas. These are further divided into two, abiotic and biotic. Abiotic means the non-living agents which can transfer the pollen grains from anther to the stigma. And in case of biotic agents, the living organisms or the living agents are involved in the transferring of pollen grains. Then in case of details, abiotic agents which are further can be divided into two, as water and wine. If water is used as a medium, if it is used as a carrier to to transfer the pollen grain from anther to stigma. Then it is known as hydrophily. The plants are called as hydrophilous plant and the flowers will be called as hydrophilous flower. This case is possible in case of aquatic plants. Those plants are aquatic. Then water is a medium, water is a agent which is used to carry the pollen grains from anther to the stigma. Phenomenon is called as hydrophily. Example is Vallisneria. Means in case of Vallisneria plant, pollen grain can be transferred through the water. Then in case of wind, if wind is used as a medium of transport of pollen grain, then that phenomenon is known as anemophily. And the flower will be called as anemophilous flower and plant will be called as anemophilous plant. Example is maize. Means in case of maize plant, pollen grain can be transferred with the help of air or with the help of wind. Then the third type, or in case of second type, biotic agents. The first type will be if the pollen grain will be transported through the insects. Then the phenomenon will be known as entomophily. Plant is called as entomophilous plant and flower will be called as entomophilous flower. What is meant by entomophily? If insects are used as a medium of transport for the transportation or for the transfer of pollen grain from anther to the stigma, then it is called as entomophily. Example is jasmine, rose. Then if birds are used as a medium of transport, then it will be called as ornithophily. Plants will be called as ornithophilous plant and flowers will be called as ornithophilous flowers. Example is bombax. The last type is if bat is used for the transport of pollen grain, then that phenomenon is called as chiropterophily. Plants will be called as chiropterophilus and flowers will be called as chiropterophilous flower. Example is anthocephalus. Then means there are five different agents which are used for the transfer of pollen grain from anther to the stigma, which are water, wind, insect, bird and bat. Means there are five different phenomena or five different ways of transportation. First is hydrophily, that is through water. Second is anemophily, through air or wind. Entomophily, through the insect. Ornithophily, through the birds. And chiropterophily, through the bat. And the examples will be different. Then now, why all these five methods will be developed? Why there is a single medium is there for the transportation of pollen grains? As the flower or as the plant shows certain adaptations. That adaptations known as floral adaptation. Means the plant or the flower shows certain adaptation to follow these pathways. For example, in case of Vallisneria, Vallisneria perform the hydrophily. Why it performs the hydrophily? The first adaptation, that is, it is aquatic. The plant is aquatic. Second, plant body. Plant body shows aquatic habitat. Then pollen grains. Pollen grains are covered with a mucilage layer to avoid the wastage of pollen grain. If mucilage layer is absent, then what happens? The pollen grain will be undergoes rotten and there is wastage of pollen grain. Hence, it must be covered with a mucilage layer or waxy coating. Then what about stigmas? Stigmas must be receptive. When on the surface of water, when pollen grain gets floating, these stigmas must be receptive and it catch the pollen grain. Then flower. Flower will be adapted for the aquatic adaptations. Calyx and corolla, they also will be covered with the waxy coating to protect the androecium and gynoecium. Then in case of anemophilous flower or anemophilous plant, there are also certain adaptations which are known as floral adaptation in anemophilous flower. Then what are these adaptations? First one, what about plant body? In case of maize plant, we will see that the male flowers will be at the top and plant body is slender. Then the, as maize being a monocotyledonous plant, at the internodal section there are number of leaves. These are the male flowers and the female flowers which are at the base or at the axial position. Means when pollen grains released from this, they easily transported or they easily carried through the vine up to the female flower or up to the stigmas. Then what about pollen grains? Pollen grains must be large in number. They must be numerous. Why? To avoid the wastage. Then one more adaptation in case of pollen grain. Pollen grain must be light in weight to easily carry through the air. Then stigmas. Stigmas must be feathery and receptive to receive the pollen grains. And flowers. Flowers are nectarless, inconspicuous. Then next to the entomophily. In case of entomophily, or if the pollination takes place by insects, the flowers must be with nectar and fragments. If a large amount of fragments is there, insect must be attracted towards the flower. Flower must be attractive in color and large in size. Then plant body may be a large. And pollen grains and stigmas. What about pollen grains? Pollen grains must be large in number and stigmas must be receptive. The most important adaptation, that flower must be with nectar and fragments. Then in case of birds or in case of ornithophily, what are the floral adaptations? Once more, the flowers must be with nectar. Then it must be with fragrance and the flowers are edible in nature. Means the parts of flower like calyx and corolla, they may be soft and easily edible to the birds. Then last one, chiropterophily. In case of this, as being bad, it is used as a medium of transportation. The flowers are nocturnal in nature. Nocturnal nature, as being bat is used as a medium of transfer of pollen grains. And flowers must be large in size for the sitting or arrangement of a bat. Means there are certain floral adaptation. They may be in case of plant body, in case of pollen grain, in case of stigma or in case of flower. They may be changed according to their type of or the medium of transportation. Means in the type or in the topic of pollination, we have studied the type of pollination, agents of pollination and the certain floral adaptations according to the agencies of pollination. Thank you.